Hello guys, welcome to my YouTube channel. And this video, the video I'm gonna do right now is masks. So we are working with masks. So I'm sorry, I will do a video on when you see the masks. I'm working with masks, okay? So I will do a short first video so that you guys will see it clearly that I'm working with masks. So I want you guys to stick with me. I just want to give you guys that inner sight on. I just want to show you guys that you can use your masks to create digital painting. You understand? I just want you guys to have that mindset that you can use your mask to create digital painting on this. So I want you guys to stick with me as I do this digital painting with mask as a beginner. So if you're a beginner, you're definitely gonna learn from this. I promise you this. You're gonna learn from this. So just stick with me while I work on this. So for further ado, let's back into the game. So yeah, this is the picture I'm gonna use. But first of all, we're gonna do the sketching. So first of all, we just create new layer, apply white to it. So let's apply white to the layer. Once you apply the white, so reduce the opacity. So let's say okay, 20 is okay. So create another new layer again. I'm using mask, so this is not matter. I'm using the mask. So put so in this process I'm going to use Photoshop brushes, so I'm not going to use any extra brushes. So we're using Photoshop brush to do all this digital painting. That will make it unique and easy for you to understand that you can use any brush. It's just that if you have the, you know, so for, to make it easy for you, you can create your own brush. So in this process I'm going to use Photoshop brushes. So let's go to brush and pick Photoshop brush. Let's go. So click on your brush. Let's use this hard edge or soft edge. Let's use this soft. Let me see. Let's use the brush. So make sure your hardness is zero. Just reduce the brush to something. 6 is okay. Okay, that will be okay. So turn it to black. So we work with this. What we just need, we just need to have that shape. We just need to have the sketch done and know where we are applying the color from. So let's reduce, let's still reduce it. Okay, this will be okay. So we are working with the mask now. So this is the sketching. So first of all, I'm gonna show you guys how you can do your pressure. So implement your pressure on mask, because mask don't have that sensor on that pressure stuff. So what you just need to do, you just need to reduce the opacity here. Reduce your opacity, because pressure work with this opacity. So when you reduce your opacity to maybe 60, 50 is okay. So even when you write your top, it will become darker and darker and darker. That's how pressure works. So I hope you guys are hearing the words pen pressure. So this is a pressure. I just created one. So we are going to work with the pressure, so that this will make it easy for us. So let's just go back to the beginning. Okay, so let's begin. So I want you guys to have that idea on how you can create digital painting with mask. So I know this line may not straight, but I hope you guys will learn from this and implement it to your own painting, and you can work with your mask on Photoshop. So those of you that say these people are using Advantage because they are using tab, I know tab is good. It's good for you to have your own tab too, but if you don't have, you can still work perfectly on mask. You can still create something nice with mask, because I used mask before I even get my part. So that is it. I'm just doing the sketching to know So you don't need to go back again. If you feel like you want to start from the beginning, you can just use your eraser to wipe this rough line out. So wipe the rough line. So we just need to know where we are applying the colors in. So we can still use I will show you another trick on how you can do this thing. Because first of all, the reason why I'm doing the sketching is for me to know where I'm applying the colors in. So if to say I just want to do some realistic card painting, I will use my pencil to do the shaping and everything. But in this process, I just want to know what we are doing, because we are doing digital painting, so we just need to have the sketch down. So that I'm using it as for a beginner. Beginner can understand what I'm doing right now. So you cannot say that I'm using an advantage. Yes, so no, I'm using mass. So you can even see that the line is not straight. So I'm using mass. So I just want you to have that mindset that you can use mass to create digital painting. So yeah. I'm not gonna fast forward this video because I just want you to have that flow in you that you can do painting with the mass. So there we go. I use eraser to clean that line. So if you miss out of it, you can just use eraser to clean it. So just keep moving on. That's why it's mass. So don't need the line to be straight. All you just need to know where we are implementing the colors in. And so you don't need to do this and say. So if you want to do that, you can just still maybe do it like this. So you can just implement something like this here. If you want to add that strong guide, so what we just need is just this, and also we can just add this to it. So and same with this. So there are certain types of fish that you will still see that have different things, so you will implement those on it. So that is for you. So guys, so this is what I need, and I need this. So this is what we need for this painting. So we can remove this. We have the shape already. So what we are going to do now is very simple. Bring this opacity back to your 100. As easy as it is. So you just first of all convert this to smart object. You convert it to smart object. So you just double click it which is just your right click to double click, your left click, sorry, on your mouse. So double click it and go to the layer. Just drag the layer out so that you can see something that you are working on. So reduce it, okay, and bring it here. So, yeah. We are working with this. So first of all, go back to the same layer, create new layer. First of all, this is your sketch layer, just lock it. Reduce the opacity first and lock it. So when you lock it, create new layer where you will apply the colors to. So we just need two colors from here because it's a white background, so definitely the white is reflecting on our fix. So you got to understand how to use this, your light stuff, so your light stuff. So you just need to, go to use your pick tool to, or your alternate to pick your colors. Pick the color you need into your brush. So you can bring the opacity back to 100, just apply the color here, the color you need, and so we need this. We need this to this red. Yeah. Go to the, we need this a high bulb. So we come to the lip, we need this, we need the inner one, which is the darker one, and you see, this up one is different from the down one, so just add this to the first. So we go to the hair, yeah. We just need first, we need second, and we need third. So that is for here, and probably we need this dark color here too. So let's cancel and it's in space. That we have now. We have three colors from each. It's already the eye we have four, so we have three colors for what we are doing here. Three sets of colors. So yeah. So let's begin this work and let me show you how you can apply this color to this place in the perfect way. So remember, I told you guys that I'm gonna show you guys a short way you can implement this color, because what we just need is we just need the inner scale so that we know what we are implementing colors on. So let's do this. So let's go back to our sketching. Reduce your opacity back to 50 and lock your color layer, just lock it, because we are not working on that. We don't want us to work on top of our colors. So in that process, you guys will understand that what we are doing now is very easy for anybody who is using Photoshop to work on. So yeah, so let's go create new layer. Just create new layer, go to your pen tool, use your pen tool just to follow the, you can even close your layers and just work, close your sketch layers, just sketch this out. First of all, you just need to have that straight line on what we are doing. As I come out, so the reason why I do the sketching, I can use that sketch line to work on this painting, but since you are a beginner or you have the experience already, so if you have the experience, just be patient with those beginners on this. So we subscribe to the channel. Please subscribe to the channel. Make sure you subscribe to the channel. Even if you download this video out of this place, make sure you subscribe to this channel. Please go back to my channel, subscribe, turn on the notification bell, because I have more to do. I have more to do on this channel. So sorry, let me plug my iPad because I'm using it to record my voice. So just a minute. So yeah, we're back. Just hold your timing so you can be able to move this. So just move it down. Keep going. Hold your timing to be able to move this to where you want it to be. So I just take it from here. Since you have, you just take it from here like this. And yeah. What we need, we just need to go back to, we can cover it back with our layer. Just take our layer back to 100 and yeah, bring it back to our sketch. So what we just need to do, we just need to implement this color. Just create a group, a new folder called group. So just name it digital painting. So play this layer, name it skin. So we are doing it in a different part. So name it skin and right click, fill part. First of all, let's set the color first. We are using this first light color. We are using the lightest color. So right click, fill part. So for background color. So we are working on this color here. Yeah? We are working on this color. So just click OK. So fun. This is fantastic because, as I'm teaching you guys, I'm still learning from you, because it takes me years to even get to know how to use masks on this on Photoshop, because it's not easy to use masks on Photoshop, because people think that usually when you have your tablet and every other thing, so no, you know, you don't need to even bother to for that on that. So right now you can see that we have some lines that some sketches are too. Doesn't matter what we just need. So when you take it out, you see that we still have the final shape on. But we still need to have this is why I do the sketch, for us to know where we are applying the colors on. Applying the colors in. So we are working with pencil, we are also working with our brush. So try to understand this. So we can create new layer now. I will try to do this on maybe probably 2 to 3 layer, so that we can understand what we are doing. I don't want us to go wider and be having different types of layer that would confuse. I don't want to confuse you, because I don't use that way anymore. So I work with maybe probably 2 layers or 1 layer. As you can see, we are working on 2 layers now, because which is the two D flat colors and create another new layer on top that we are working on, that that will be the TVD. That is when we are going to apply colors to colors that will make it look 3D now. So let's go back into the game. So first, just carry on brush and use your soft edge, because we are using soft edge here. Soft round, so let's call it soft round. So call it soft edge. So it doesn't mean. So take this one and reduce the opacity to probably 50, or make it 40. We are creating the pressure now. Just watch the magic. So you can see it now. The more I press it, the more darker it is. So let's work with this. First of all, go to your layer, your sketch layer, make it multiply, turn it to multiply. So reduce it to probably 30 is okay. 30 is okay. Lock it back. Just lock it and go back to your new layer. So increase your brush. Increase your brush here. Let's start working. So in this process now, we are blocking, we're just bringing the colors in and knowing where we are putting the colors. You can still increase it if you don't have the darkness you are looking for. So just keep applying colors here. So just click this color, that's all we have color here. Just click it and you can still increase it. So turn it to 100 back. Just keep blocking it this way. Just want to add that block shape first of all before we go more further. So make it block shape. So more of that anyway. So we come back to this this color, which is, let me say red on this color here. So just apply it to this here. So we have that reddish there. So can I reduce our brush? I'm using Photoshop brush, I'm not using any other brush. So just reduce it to probably 41 is okay. So I'm looking at the picture, the reference picture here, to work on this. can use your Ctrl Z, you can go back, so, or you can just paint on top of it, so it's your choice. You don't have the darkness you really want on the picture. You can just pick from this same dark place and make the colors in that process. You have that dark line that you are looking for. So you can just come back here, pick this white. You see this skin is lighter than what I picked before. You can see. You see. So just pick it. You can just see. So let's just add this light skin here. So that will be easy for us to work on. So let's go back to our hard edge. Let's apply this color again. So you can see the color. This color is different. So what we just need to do is just click the color. Click the color just like we can apply this color here. So you see that we have different color now. So let's work. Let's go back. What I simply did is just let's remove this the second layer. This is our main color. This is the color that I'm supposed to pick. So I make that is my own fault. So I hope you guys understand. So this is the color I need, this inner color, which is the light form. Let's call it form of the light. So the lightest color, that's what I need to use as a 2D before I start implementing this tone and every other colors in. So let's go back to the job. So yeah. So let's just take back our color, this which is the lighter color, and make it right now. So go back to your round edge brush. I reduce the opacity to 40, 41, but 40 is okay, so let's apply it now. You see, they will be different now. So come back to this last time and plus of the magic cell like this. So they will be different now. So we are getting the shape now, we are getting the shape for what we are doing. And just implement it here. So we are getting the shape of what we are doing. So it's not difficult to work with mouse. Just that if you understand what you are doing, that I want you guys to understand it. So please like this video so that other people can see this video too, and other people can watch this video and learn from this method I'm using, which is creating your own pressure. What we just did, we use our mask to create our own pen pressure here, so that you can work with your mask. Like, you know, you are using the tablets or the thing. So the more you work with this, you get this easy and you'll be fast in all what you do. So yeah. So if we remove our sketch line layer now, you see we're having the shape already. So we're having the shape already. So don't worry, we are going to go to that extent where you're like, wow, is this mask? Am I using mask? So you just watch it and you love it. So stick with me on this. I know the camera looks like this, and I'm looking this. So my monitor is here, and the camera is here, so you can see even that I face the camera now. So I'm working on this here. So let's go back to the game. I really love this. So. So we just come here, lighting this stuff here. Remember, there is light on that, so that's why when you remove your sketch layer, you're not seeing anything here. So let's add our lights here now. So let's go and pick our light skin and just add it here. So you know what you're doing. You can reduce, you can see reduce it to lower. So we have that feeling that there is light here, so that the shape on that there will show. So let's move the layer. You can see the shape is coming up, so you can amend that. So we'll just add it first before. So let's amend it. Remember, we are using one layer on this, so you don't need to create more layer, but if you insist on creating more layer. So if you have been using mask, creating more layers, so you don't need to create more layers. Just like, I just want to show you guys that you can do it. Even I can even work with just a single layer on this painting. So I'm just doing it so that you guys can understand what I'm doing right now. So just cover it up and so you can see now remove it, and you see they're having the shape there already. So let's cover this, let's blend this, yeah. So we have that feeling we are working on something. When I started using my mask, I was using eraser and pencil to fill colors and erase it. Nowadays I don't need to do that because I have the ideas now on how to do it in an easier format. In a way that I can even understand it more better. So we don't need so you like how you doing it? So I just click just one touch, I just pick the color that I need, just click it once and just drag each one. But if I just want to apply double tens, remember it's like pressure, the way you press it, that's how the color will come out. So if you want it more darker, just take the first line, take the second time, it will become darker because you are using mask. So even if you press it hardly, it will not press, it will not work. So you are using mask, so you just do it step by step. It's like step by step clicking into tens down for you to be using eraser. You don't need eraser on this, you don't need to suffer yourself much. So yeah, I wanted to use a dark lady, but it seems like people were like, because of an African guy, that's why. So I just want to use what will fit. I know white is very difficult to paint, white color is very difficult to paint. To me it's difficult, but to others it may be easy. So to me it's difficult to paint. If you understand the logics, you need to use the page again. So, yeah. So, when we remove the sketch layer, and you see, we are bringing something out here. So, let's go to the skin. Let's just work on the body so that we know what we are doing here. So, yeah, it's very easy. Just increase your brush and melt it on the edge. To bring this out is very easy. Just once you apply the colors like this, just drop it on top. Come back to your light color. Just drop the light color here. As you can see, just grab it already. So It's as easy as you see. Just take the right color again. So that I need that particular direction to me. You have that feeling as you're doing the dress. See, the reason why we created this layer, this is our guide to know what we are applying on and what we are doing. So we just need this guide. Just taking a pop and so I can be seeing this clearly, you know. I'm seeing it very clearly. Okay. Don't be afraid to apply the colors. Remember, I made it so don't be afraid of the colors and just do it anyway. Have that self-confidence. So in this process, you are going to be reducing the brush. Even if you are using tablet to reduce the brush, you increase it. So that's how you can work on the painting. So if you don't reduce the brush, because even you yourself know that you are going to reduce the brush, you reduce it and keep the flow going. Let's keep working. So let's remove the ISC. Wow. Okay. They're still working on it. Okay, let's go back to our face. It's like we are done with the skin. Just like that. You can still go further. Just keep applying the visualize and that will make it come out. Nice, the key is not dark, so let's take this dark color here. So let's add it. So let's go back to the face and let's do this touch here. So this is work with the light through. Always follow your light and know just learn how to push it up. So we are just pressing it, so like we are pressing it and bringing it back. So that is the clear. Yeah. So, using the light, just following the light and how you are pressing it and giving it back. So, to push that, let's just come back to it. Let's increase the canvas, right? Increasing the canvas, let me make it back. Okay. Just increasing it. But don't be afraid to apply your colors, because because this edge of here, you see that there's this piece here, because of the light is like covering it up. So you just use your own idea to bring add some colors here that will not be brighter. That's why you see that here is not brighter. It's only here that is bright. So just add it to this place and let's finish this nose and so we can go to the lips. It's very easy. It's very difficult. So this is very easy. So it's not difficult anymore. So we can do it. It's not difficult to do. So if you are finding it difficult, it's just that you are not solving the problem here. So where we paint it, we like we are solving problems here. You know. Adding it, and if you watch one thing, and you see that I'm still working on one layer. So once I remove this layer, now you see everything go back to the flat color. So we are working on one layer, bringing all these things that we are not doing any other layer. So we are working on this layer. The only when we are going to the hair, we are doing another layer. So Let's go. Touch this color back and apply it on the ear. The reason why the ear is red is that it's because of the light. So when light touches your skin, that place will be red. So your blood inside will be showing. So this is blood. This is blood. How you want your pressure to look like, let me say pressure, so you know how you want your opacity to look like, because if you are using mouse, you need to work with your opacity, so you need to work with your opacity so that you can have the flow in your mouse and have the control over your paint and the way you apply your paint on your digital painting. Okay, there we go. Check it in that this one is darker. So, I know you're like, this ear will be difficult. It's not difficult. It's just that once we start applying the light on that ear, you see that the ear will pop out and you see. This edge, you just apply light to the edge, and yeah, that would bring it out. Let's see, let's remove the layer. Line, so you can see the ear now. The ear is coming out, so yeah, I'd like to. Yeah. Light is everything, so it's your light that will bring it out more. Okay. Let's pay this guy to him. So I can hand it to him. So. Sorry about that. Let me save it. Let me save it. Working with one layer here, so if you insist of creating double layer, so that would be easy for you. You are free to do that. It's your own way. I know this is not difficult for anybody to do. So just pick white here. You can just pick white from the background. So if you are using white background, so you can reduce your brush to reduce it back to 40. Just if you want it to chill. Those are things that, so it will be easy for you to do. So, yeah. I want it to be easy for everybody. So, yeah. Just need to take this first color. So the inner drop, so it goes. So we pick our lighter color. First of all, let's just make it sharp and just make the outline for the what we are doing. Let's add this lighter color first. So let's just put it in the middle. So add the black one. So can use this one to 20. As you can see, just stick it around it. Sorry about that. Stick it around this step. Can pick color from here and just make it the same. So do the same here. So just pick white here, just pick any white here. So let's make it 100 and make it add, let's put it on brand edge. Just apply the white here and I still apply it somewhere if you assist, but we are just following the photo we are working on. So go back to your round edge. Let's go back to our round edge. Reduce it to 21 and make some light colors here. So, but we are working with our mass here. So please subscribe if you want me to do more on this, and just subscribe if you don't understand this, please leave it on the comment below. I'll try my best to answer it for you. So subscribe to my channel, please don't let me to cry, please subscribe, please guys, subscribe to my channel, please. pursue what we are doing. Okay. Going somewhere. Yeah. So let's go back to this dark color. Let's see if we pick the color correctly. Let's see. Yes, we did. So let's apply the color down here so we know what we are doing. Just need to hold on there and just go back to, let's go to the leap. So because of time, you know, time is not our friend, you know. I'm just trying to do this for a few times. So if you want to use your pen tool, you can still be using your pen tool to make it easy for you. But since we are working on, so I don't, it's not advisable for you guys to use pen. But if you see that you can use pen, just use your pen. You understand? Just use your pen. So that's what I can say. Just use your pen if you insist. If you know that would be easy for you to have this shape easy, because the more you work with this process, the more better you become in this process. So I understand. So if you have no choice than to use your pen, you can use your pen. So I prefer using the brush, so that will make me become better on this side. Just take it down. Remember, we are making it to pop out, so yeah. So if you want to add detail to the lip, you just reduce your brush and be pressing it this way. Yeah, that is the only way you can add detail to the lip. Still reduce your brush and be pressing it with your nose. Use your brush now and just bring this darker side out. So just the reason why you need to have the guide, so the guide will show you what you need to do, and you know, so that's why you need to have that guide at the first place. So but if you have your own way of doing your own painting, it's still okay for me. So but if you want to learn the process of mass, so you just still need to let go of some things and add some things. Just take something that anything you know that this will help you out, add it to your own way of painting. So that is the only way you can learn more and have that more ideas on what you are doing. Okay. If you want to see how your little effect, you can just keep doing it this way. So I know I'm not zooming it, so I'm just working at it. So I just look at the reference to working on this place, so that will improve my own setup, seeing my own painting in other aspects. Just give it that shadow. Remember the shadow, this, which is this circle here. So we just give him the shadow so that it will pop up. So So let's go. So, trying to bring out so just trying to pop it out more, and so you guys will understand it as easy as it is now. So I'm working with the lights and just knowing the right place to apply the lights and can still come back here and just pick this lighter color and start painting it. So, because we're almost done with the painting, so. We are just using the brush tool, so yeah. All you just need is a brush tool. So this is Photoshop brush. I'm not using any. This is the general brush. So don't use any other brush. So. Trying to get that light flow. I can just add some darker color as well. I have that darkness here. So you can see I'm trying to get the darkness here. So that still add the red and just reduce the opacity, because add it here and add it here. Increase your opacity again. So we are working with opacity here. So yeah. and just to pick the red again. So let's pick the color and still add it, which is your opacity which you get. So let's add it here. Maybe dabla. But anyway, the light touch. So because of the force of the light, that's why that place is red. So that place is red. So because of the light. And still come to this make and add light to the make. So you can increase it. So add light. So as you can see, you see light here, that's why this ear is not showing. So once we apply the light to that place, you see that this thing will be different. Now let's apply the light. So let's apply it. So let's use the guideline now. So yeah, now so can see, look at the edges now, look at it. So you can just pick white here and just apply it to the nails, which is there. So I think that will be okay for now because of the time. So let's go to the hair. So now we are going to create a new layer for the hair. See, we work with just one layer, so just one layer. So we are going to the hair now. So so this is the hair layer. So this is what we are going to do. So we pick the hair already, so we are picking the darker color first. So let's just use the darker color to pass it first. You see the pressure that I'm telling you guys about. So you see, when I pass it the first time, it's not dark. So when I pass it again, it becomes dark. That is how you need to work with your, you got to know how you can use your opacity. So that is the only way you can apply these colors easily. So we're still going to darken this line here, which is this line. So I just wait for, let's work on this first. Let's go to the bigger one. you can see in prison, like, so I have this, use your eraser to erase this side, this part that you don't need. Create another new layer. This is why we are creating this new layer, because of just want to make it easy for us to apply other colors, so that we can still go back. If we don't like what we are doing, we can still go back, because this is hair style. So first of all, let me finish this. Let's go to the second layer. This part of the layer. So click on this and just make, let's just make our brush opacity to become 50. So let's have that flow there. Okay, let's go now. So we are just doing it step by step. So just be patient with yourself. Just be patient with yourself. I'm still using the same round brushes. I'm not using any brushes. So we are still working with the same brushes. Just want to make you guys to understand that this is possible for you to use mask to paint your painting. You can even use one brush to paint your painting. Start even going into another brush, which is the soft edge. I'm just using the soft edge to work on this. So we're going to reduce the brushes now. So I'll just reduce our opacity a little bit so that we can do some. Or let's just reduce our brush to this stage. Okay. So we did our opacity, you understand? So we work with the opacity here, so I'm just to reduce it and so let's add the white line. So just pick white here, so you can just use white to do it, which is the white string. So just be loosey and just need to reduce our brush. Let's reduce our brush. Let's take time. Just trying to use the mask to come back. I'm just trying to be lucid here because this is the part where I'm using just the line and I just reduce the brush to one so I can have that flexibility. So I can stay lucid. Yeah, so the hair don't need to look accurate with the same hair, but try to make it, you know. So, just to pick here and just be doing it, so put back the white time. Try to be lucid, be patient with yourself. I know time is going, I know the video is long, but be patient. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Please do subscribe to my channel because that will help me a lot. Subscribe to the channel, please. So be patient with yourself, keep doing it to your taste. Stay lucid, just stay lucid, just keep doing it and probably there is no shortcut on this, so you just have to do it. I think you can still bring back this dark side, just increase it and remove the dark string into to another effect that so I just increase the opacity to 80. So I'm using a darker color so I can have that effect over here. As you can see, we are working with mass here. We are not using any pen tablets, so fuck pen tablets, you know. But you still need to have it too. So you have the idea that you can create something like this. Sorry, I used that word fuck here, so sorry. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Please subscribe to the channel, you know. Subscribe to the channel. Subscribe to the channel. Please be patient with yourself here, you know. Be patient. You can do it. This is the process where it's very difficult, so you have to be patient with yourself. Be lucid. This is mass. You are not using pen tablet, so definitely you are not going to have that sharp edges, which is the pressure, you know. So all the edges are the same. Okay, let's see what we have done.
Yeah, we did it together.
See, so we don't need the guideline, but we still need it in one part. So I will show you the part. So let's work with this. I'm trying to bring us the line there, so we can go back to our. We now come back to the down layer, so we work on that. So we just want to bring those string of lines. So we just bring the down line underneath. So it will look like the hair is coming from the down, so it's like something from the skin. So you push on to yourself. Start to blend, you just press a Ctrl Z. That is why you are using mass. So I understand. Go back to your up layer, just add some string here. So yeah, here we go. We are doing it together. So let's go to the eyebrow. Let's do the eyebrow the same, but the eyebrow is very easy, so we don't need to go that far. So just reduce the opacity, add the strength. So eyebrow is not that difficult to do. So just add the strength. You will see. Still will see this. So you can do that side down. Do the same. So we'll come back to the down layer, just add it underneath, so we have that flow. Same with this underneath, so we have that flow. Yeah, so let's go back to our skin. We just need to add some dark areas here, and yeah. About 2 hours now, so just need to have that effect. So we just take our red, remember, so just add our red here. This repeats had already a little bit. And she can see because of this that dark line over there, so we just speak from the nose line. Let's try to answer. Close it up. So. So let's add the eye line. So just go back to your hair and pick the dark side, pick this black and just take it around it like this. Same with this. So, it was like, just trying to put on. So let's add the rest and just increase the opacity. So, we're going to add those little strings and elements. So, let's just add these lines to it. So, that will make it more. get this one right, so let's make it right. So for increase the opacity and reduce the brush. Increase this a bit, okay. Let's add it. Trying to add the pressure to the sharp edges to it, so that's why. I see adding some light to it. Back to our skin and in this process now we are going to go back to the skin and make some place look more realistic, you know, try to make some place adjust some light effect and make it track. We're almost done, so be patient, okay? So let's go back. As you can see, look here, there's no dark side, so we have to divide it into something like this. So just bring out some whites here. So let's add some red to this edge here too. There we go. Let's pick from the color, so let's see if we can add some. Yeah, this is too cool, it's sweet. I feel like here is not straight, you can stick out for me, so I think that is okay for me. Yeah. So this is the painting, and I think this is what where I can go reach. I can still go further than this, but for this video I just want to cut it from here. So thank you guys for watching this video. Thank you guys for subscribing to my channel, and please, if you have not subscribed, please subscribe. And if this video helped you a lot, put it on the comment below. What you don't understand, leave it on the comment below, because I will be able to answer your questions. And also, if I make some wrong moves. So I like if professional watch this video and understand that maybe I made some mistakes. Put it on the comment below. When I make it right, put it on the comment below. Please turn your notification bell on, so that once I post another video on this, you will be the first to notice. So peace.